Hello? Are you? I'm hearing that somebody say wants to give me 5 million. That's what I'm hearing. Cannot hear you.
Yeah.
Kilo to move Skype by to you lo do marry. So to not do quarantine me.
All right, so how have you been managing during this lockdown? How have you been managing?
Yes, not really managing. We are trying to keep the spirit high, energy up. Though I'm already looking like a biblical hero. No, Baba. Lockdown. I'm looking like John the Baptist.
You're looking like what your name is. Your name is Woli. So Woli. We expect that, that's exactly how you look. This morning you put up a post on your Instagram celebrating Gbenga Adeboye, 17 years. Was he also like a mentor to you? I mean, I know that this was a long time ago, but what was he to
actually,
you as a person?
For me, I've been doing a show on my IG Live, which is Chat Room with Woli Arole. It's really been awesome, where I bring legends from all across, you know, the world, and they come on my Instagram Live. I celebrate those that have done impactful stuff in the entertainment industry in Nigeria and beyond. We brought Ayuba, we brought Bola Re. That was the day I did an industry night for Barbara. It's also late. So, you know, today now makes it 17 years that the legendary Tubaba Itafunwotongbe in that boy is gone. So we're just celebrating him today. So it's just an initiation for me to celebrate people, bring people also to the room. So that is why we are doing it that for Gbenga Adeboye.
What has the response been for you personally? I know that it's been, a lot of people have been on it, but for you personally, are you achieving what you aimed?
Yes. You know, and the most powerful part of it is every day I get prayers from people, DM, calls, text messages of how some of the guests we bring have inspired them. You know, people didn't see this dimension coming. You know, they just felt it was going to be the normal general, you know, shouting and, you know, but it's quite inspiring. And the objective of it is just people coming with their stories and they're using that story to inspire people. I just felt that everybody has a story to tell. You that you're talking to me, you have a story to tell. Everybody has a story. And in every story, there is a lesson to learn, experiences, inspiration. So, you know, at first, people thought it was this normal joke, but now it's really, really amazing. It's transformational. People have reason not to give up, just to keep moving. What you're going through, some people had gone through it already, and they came out strong.
Is being funny enough to be successful as a comedian? Is being funny enough?
For me, based on my experience and the experience I've gathered, you know, in the entertainment industry, within and outside Nigeria, I would say anybody can be funny. I feel comedy is a craft, is intentional. It needs to be deliberate. There are some actions you need to take to be either a stand-up comedian or a comic actor, whichever form, or you're a content creator that does comedy. So for me, I feel that it is intentional. It's very, very professional. It's very, very, it's just like someone that knows how to cook, doesn't mean you're a chef. There are some things you put in together to be a chef. Being funny is part of the ingredient, but that is not the totality of it. You need to learn how to do it well. You need to learn when to do it. You know, there's a lot of things just in it.
Woli, you need to pray us out of the show now. We've come to the end of the show. Say, just prophesy into our lives as we wrap
up. And prophesy into the lives of those at home who are still in quarantine right now.
Is that you want to give me that 4 million? Let me give my account number. 00.